Hi, Hope Kids and Jam friends. This week's Word Up is God can use me. Sometimes we may feel we're too little, too young, or too weak to do something, but we don't have to do it alone. God shows how powerful He is, and He wants to use us to do His good work. Listen to today's story as the Bible tells about someone who felt he couldn't do what God wanted him to do. Do you remember what happened to the Israelites every time they tried living their own way instead of living in God's way? The Israelites were living evil lives, and God let them suffer the consequences of their sin so that they will learn from their mistakes. However, because God still loved them so much, God sent judges to rescue the Israelites from the consequences of their sin. In Judges 6, people called Midianites were stealing or destroying all the Israelites' food for 7 years. God had warned the Israelites that their sin would have consequences, and now they were in trouble because, again, they had not listened to God. When the Israelites begged God to rescue them from the Midianites, God chose a man named Gideon, another judge, a special real-life hero who would rescue the Israelites. But, you know, when I think of a hero, I imagine someone who is bold and courageous and powerful. But this time, God chose Gideon, who was hiding and was scared. Gideon felt he couldn't do what God wanted him to do. How would you feel if God chose you and asked you to do a really hard task, such as, you know, rescuing His people from suffering? Maybe, you know, sometimes God asks you to help someone who's being bullied, and but you feel really afraid to stand up for them. Have you ever felt like you couldn't do what God wanted you to do? You know, it can be hard, and you might feel like you can't do God's good work all on your own, and you don't have to. God has the power to help you do the good things that He wants you to do. In Ephesians 2:10, it says, "For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do." When you and I obey and trust in God and do the good things God has prepared us for us to do, we are honoring God and pleasing Him. Say it with me. God can use me. God was going to use Gideon, but Gideon felt like he couldn't do what God was asking. He knew it was impossible for the Israelites to win a fight against the powerful Midianite army. But the Lord said, "I will be with you, and you will strike down all the Midianites, leaving none alive." God, the powerful king over everything, promised to be with Gideon. Later, the Midianites and other enemies of the Israelites all grouped together in one huge army and prepared to attack the Israelites. There were more enemies than you could count. It would take you all day and you still couldn't count all of those enemy soldiers. With God's help, Gideon also gathered an army of Israelite men to fight with him. Lots of men came to help, but the Israelite army was still much smaller than the enemy's army. Gideon was afraid, so he asked God for a way to know for sure that God would help the Israelites. Gideon put some sheep's wool on the ground and asked God to make the wool very wet and the ground all around very dry. The next day, Gideon checked to see what God had done. Gideon squeezed an entire bowl full of water out of the wool, even though the ground all around it was very dry. But Gideon still wasn't sure that he could lead the Israelite army, and he wanted to really make sure that God was going to help him. So this time he asked God to make the ground wet, but the wool completely dry. And again, God did what Gideon asked. Isn't God so patient and so generous? You know, if it was me and my student asked me over and over again, I would be like, "Just do it. You can do it. Just do it. Stop asking me. Just do it." But God isn't like that. He is so patient, and He promises to be with us when we're feeling scared and afraid and unsure. God has the power to use you and me and Gideon, even though all of us feel like we can't do what God wanted. Now, do you think Gideon felt ready to defeat the enemy's army? What will Gideon and the Israelite men do against thousands of enemy soldiers? How will they fight against them? Also, God does something crazy and even more amazing. To listen to the rest of this message, go to the Hope Church website and watch part two of this week's sermon message. Thank you to friends who posted prayer requests online. Let's all continue to pray this week for God to use each and every one of us to do His good work for His kingdom.